We are about to embark upon a series of strange and exciting dangerous adventures. Adventures that will lead us to all parts of the world.
Hello and welcome to another Bad Comic Review. This time we're looking at Xira, issue 1 from Stonebot and Red 5. Script by Mauro, Mantella. Art by Diego Giribaldi. Colors by Ramon, Bunge. Lettering by Altercomics Studio. Cover by Giribaldi and Bunge. The cover's actually kind of cool. It does give you a little bit of a hint as to what you can expect. Revisions by Sarah Lindsay, Leonardo Polini Summers, and Chris Ortega. So the basic premise is there are people experimenting on apes and monkeys, and they are trying to make super monkeys to do space exploration, and they've only had one success, and that's Xira. Xira had a child with another ape, and the child is probably also super smart. It looks like there's some sort of cybernetic implant as well as various other things. This chimpanzee wants its baby back, and it's not going to stop at any cost, and it knows how to use a gun too. Now that premise sounds really cool. The downside is that the dialogue in here, about 90% of it is really terrible. And some of the situations are a little stupid. Like there's a zoophile doctor. That was a little unnecessary. She can be resentful of the doctor because of the experiments, not because he's a perv. Since the chimpanzee can talk, it does add a little bit to it. But we've got these like caricature scientists who are so cavalier in their hatred of apes. They have no respect for any of the animals they work on. And I don't think that's true. I think that's a stereotype, and it really takes away from the characterization. It would be more interesting if they were a little sympathetic. Instead, they're just very cut and dry evil and boring, and there's like one good scientist. It's kind of lazy writing. And then, of course, they all vastly underestimate how smart this ape is, which is also pathetic. And there's a really, really lazy scene where a security guard is about to shoot the ape. We see different parts of the animal's brain, analyzing what his personality and body type are. Like, oh, he's insecurity because he has a longing for power, and forced masculinity means problematic parental relationship. And of course she defeats him by saying, your father always loved you. It was stupid. That was such a caricature. That was just lazy writing to me. There wasn't any effective dramatic there. It was just cliche TV stuff. Otherwise, the basic premise of the story is pretty interesting. A mother trying to rescue her baby from people that were experimenting on both of them, and it really felt like there was a lot more potential here that went unrecognized because of the lazy dialogue and that stupid scene with the security guard. I think that really hurt the book, so I'm not going to recommend it. It had a great idea that was just lost because they were trying to do some really lazy dialogue and ham-fisted politics. It's pathetic. There's too much blinded by your own politics here for this to be effective, because the villains come off as being one-dimensional cardboard cutouts instead of interesting characters that would have a more emotional impact. So I'm not recommending this. This is a big miss, and I'm really disappointed by that, because like I said, the premise was interesting. But that's just my take. Thank you so much for listening and supporting the channel. If you enjoyed the video, please hit the like button, and don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss future reviews. If you'd like to help the channel in other ways, links to my Patreon, Streamlabs, and Teespring are in the description. And as always, we hope to see you on the next one.